Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Katlego. If you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to another video. So today I want to discuss something that I've seen a lot in the comment section. So usually whenever I upload a video that, I don't know, some people would say negative. I don't think it's negative. I think it's just painting like the full picture. So for example, I did a video sometime last year talking about things I wish I knew before going into environmental sciences, or the negatives, the cons of doing this type of qualification. And I got some videos of people being like, oh my god, I wish I knew this before I registered. Oh my god, I just registered for this, I'm a first year student. Or, oh no, I'm a second year student, are you telling me this degree is basically going nowhere? So I just wanted to make a video talking about things you can do after completing your BSc environmental science degree, environmental management degree, that can sort of set you up for success. I'm not gonna say this is a surefire way of stuff, but these are some things that I have done or things I wish I knew while I was still doing my degree and which I think would have helped me. So let's get into the video. So this is a step-by-step guide that I've sat down and I've thought about, and I was like, if I were to go back knowing what I know now, what would I do differently? Number one, reflect on your interests and goals. This is important for whether you just started this degree now in 2024, whether you started it 2 years ago, or if you're in your final year and you're like, what am I gonna do? I think you need to reflect on your interests and goals. So say, take some time to reflect what exactly about this field interests you, specific areas or topics that you are passionate about. Again, this will help you when looking for a job, because you will know, this is the specific field within environmental sciences that I want to go into, or this is the field that I want to pursue with regards to specializing or doing a postgraduate degree. So make sure you know what in environmental sciences interests you, because there is no master's in environmental science. You have to specialize in something. Are you interested in the plant side? Are you interested in the animal side? Are you interested in climate change? Are you interested in sustainability? Are you interested in management, policy, law? All of these things. I have a video on my channel where I talk about the different specializations you can do, but this is specifically for a master's degree, because an honors depends on the institution. So reflect, what are your interests? What are your goals? Number two, consider further education and training. Specialize or study further. So you need to look at where you are. What have you done? I've done a BSc. These are the courses that I've done within my BSc, or the modules that I've done within this BSc. What is the job market looking like? In my opinion, a BSc, specifically in environmental sciences, doesn't really weigh much. You need a specialization, because again, it's a science discipline. You need to have certain skills that you can only acquire once you've done a postgraduate degree. A BSc degree is sort of like an introduction into the field. Only once you have studied further for your honors or for your masters, you have certain skills that you're able to apply in the field. So investigate whether additional qualification or certifications are valued within the market. For example, do you want to go into management? Well, you might need an environmental impact assessment certification, which is not something you can get from South African universities. Last time I checked, it's something you need to do outside of university. So it's a separate certification. Are you going to need that for the job that you want? You need to check if there are local institutions offering specialized courses or programs that align with your career goals. For example, do you want to do some type of environmental data analysis, but the institution you were studying at was not offering GIS as a specialized course? Maybe you need to look at a private institution that offers GIS and study specifically GIS, so you have that certification that will help you push you further. Again, consider whether you want to specialize in a specific field within environmental sciences, because this involves pursuing a master's degree or a PhD degree. You need to know which field you are most interested in, and research potential graduate programs or professional certifications that align with your interests. Number three, gain practical experience. So you need to seek internships, volunteer positions. I feel a little bit iffy about volunteer opportunities, especially if you are somebody like me who comes from a certain type of background. You cannot really afford to work for free. So I would say internships, entry-level positions in your chosen field, because practical experience is valuable in this particular field. If you don't have any kind of practical experience, it's very, very difficult to move further. So network with professionals in the environmental field to learn about opportunities. For example, I got to get a lot of opportunities because I was in the certain department I was in back in universities, because they would share with us entry-level positions, internships, because again, it's a network. So somebody knows somebody who knows somebody, so they're gonna tell them about a position at their company, they're gonna pass it on to people they know. So if my professor knows somebody and that person has an open position in their company, they'll be like, hey, by the way, there's this internship. And then your professor might be like, okay guys, so I have a friend of a friend of a friend, and there's this opportunity, you guys should apply. So networking, update your resume and your LinkedIn profile. So once you've completed your degree, your degrees, update your profiles, update your CV, make sure you put the latest stuff first. So if you're going to apply for a job that is like looking for somebody who knows data analysis, you need to put that skill at the top. You cannot start with your high school, because that's not your latest results, you know what I mean? So if you're going to be updating your profile, you need to put the latest stuff first. Explore job opportunities. Research, camp on websites, identify which companies you would like to work for. I've spoken about this in one of my videos. You can check it in the link in the description. You need to know which companies align the most with you and your interests. Camp on your profiles. If need be, cold email them. Explore government opportunities. Look at the websites. Keep an ear out. Look at postings. Our government is actually still like, they still post stuff on like paper things. So it's kind of difficult to find out about stuff online, but look online, look at their websites. Environmental consulting firms. There's a bunch of environmental consulting firms in South Africa. Identify which companies are environmental consulting firms, because most of the time these companies are private companies. So you need to know which companies, again, you need to know which companies are within environmental sciences and you would want to work in, and look at the type of entry-level positions that they advertise. NGOs and nonprofit organizations, again, research. Another thing would be government environmental programs, although I think it's because I was not necessarily keeping an eye out for these. So if there's like government environmental programs happening within your area that you happen to, or that you happen to know about, I would say attend these programs, because they create job opportunities where they'd be like, oh, we're looking for young people to do whatever. And as much as you think that amounts to nothing, that adds something to your CV. So you are building practical experience, and you are networking, because you're meeting people there. You can find out what people do. You can see if they can connect you with somebody. So networking. Now, three things I wish I knew, especially when I completed my qualification, my first qualification, my BSc. I wish I knew about professional certifications. Again, this is optional. It depends on your goals. You need to consider getting some done. So again, I mentioned at the beginning of this video, some certifications, you cannot find them in your new university, or universities don't really delve that much deep into certain aspects of the environment. Again, environmental impact assessment, you need a certification which you can obtain outside the university. You can get a GIS certification. I don't know much about others because these are the two that I constantly think about, so I can only speak about those. And again, it aligns with your career goals and aspirations. So look at your field, look at what's required, what certifications you would need to get, and try to see how you can get those. Networking. I didn't know much about networking until I got my internship and I got to meet people and I realized how important it is to network. So join local environmental organizations, attend conferences, attend webinars, participate in events related to environmental sciences in South Africa if you're able to. Keep an eye out. So if you're going to be camping on certain companies' websites, you're going to know if they're holding events, if they're holding webinars, if they're holding conferences, and you're able to attend these, meet people, get put yourself out there. You know, that's how you build networks. You can connect with professional or experts in the field. You can even find a mentor that way. You can find somebody to refer you. If they hear about an opportunity, they'll be like, oh, I know this girl called Katlego, she's doing this, Ibile, she has this, this, and this, and this, able to contact you and get you in contact with somebody who can give you a job. Last one, and the most important one, in my opinion, and in the circles I run, like the people I've talked to, people older than me, stay flexible and open-minded. You rarely find a job opening in this field that is specific to your degree. So look at a job posting and look at their requirements. Do you have what they need? Don't be stuck up on a title. Don't be stuck up on a name. Just because it doesn't say environmental management something does not mean you do not qualify. Look at the requirements that they need. Look at the qualifications or skills that you have. Do they match up? Apply. I think I spoke about this on the video I shot with Zolake as well, to say don't be put off by the title that they put in a job posting. Do you qualify? Yes, apply. Or do you qualify with everything else but there's this one thing that you do not have? Apply, because most likely it's probably something you can sort out as you move forward, or it's a skill you can learn on the job. And depending on how your CV looks, you might stand a great chance to get that job. But if you look at a job and you think, ah man, I didn't do environmental management, they're looking for somebody with environmental management, my degree says environmental science, and you don't apply, that's throwing away an opportunity. So stay flexible. As long as their requirements align with what you know and what you have, then be open to exploring those opportunities and explore different opportunities within environmental sciences. Again, everything is interconnected. So just because it's in environmental management doesn't mean as an environmental science graduate you don't qualify. Everything is broad, everything meets at some point. So go for it. If it's something you think you can do, definitely go for it. I think that is the most important advice I can give you, and something that I got to learn along the way. I hope this video has helped you in some type of way and can encourage you to not think you have reached a dead end. So this career is not necessarily you jumping into a hole that is never ending. It's not the end of the world. Again, a lot of people who comment, I'm like, look at it this way. At least you found this video while you're in your first year. Now you know what to look out for. Now you know the type of stuff you need to research. Now you know that these are the things I need to figure out. So you're not in a dead end versus somebody who never gets to know about it. Think of it that way. I hope this video has helped you. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.